Alright, so welcome back to another episode of Find Love or Die Trying. So now it's sometime later in the shit, so let's see what happens next. Let's do this shit. Hey Tara, how was skating? There's no words. Oh shit, I think Ali broke Tara. Scarlett waved her hands frantically in front of Tara's face, as if to check if anyone was still in there. Tara, are you in there? Hey Tara, the internet's back. There's nobody's home. Is there a medic on the island? Luckily, Tara was fine. After that was resolved, we spent the rest of the morning playing video games as therapy for Tara. She still doesn't remember a thing about what happened. What did you see, Tara? Guess we'll never know. I figured it's about time to talk with Kat about my next date, but I felt a tap on my back. Kat, is that? I turned around and the girl in front of me was as surprised as I was. Oh, Allie. Kat, no, this is Allie. Sorry, Allie, what's up? She looked to see if anyone else is around before she spoke. Have you noticed anything weird lately? What do you mean? Don't get me wrong, I had a lot of fun on a date earlier, but something about the show is weird. Uh-oh. So, Allie's probably recognized something off about the show, bruh. Though, you gotta also remember from the first episode, bruh, what they said, bruh. What Kat said. Is that I'm not allowed to tell any of the girls what's actually going on in the show, bruh. Otherwise, not only will I get killed, but the girls who find out will also get killed as well, bruh. Thing is that me, Kat, and Damien know about the whole situation, but the girls that are participating in this dating show, not so much, bruh. They don't know anything about the situation, bruh. I went for a walk in the forest last night. I know, you know, cause it's gorgeous and all. But after I got there, I must have dozed off for a minute. Taking a nap in the forest at night, you're braver than most, Allie. Let me finish. When I woke up, I was back in my room on my bed. And I swear, I don't remember ever walking back. Huh? That sounds pretty crazy. If it really happened. Maybe someone must have lifted you back into your room. You sure you didn't have a weird dream? Now that you mention it, I tried Scarlett's cooking for fun last night. That was a big mistake. Maybe I'm just imagining things, but did you notice anything strange happened last night? I don't think so. It was just a regular night. I had a conversation with Kat in my room, but that was it. Damn, 5 girls to date wasn't enough, huh? Sorry, I couldn't help myself. Well, I guess I'll just be staying away from Scarlett's cooking and chalk it up to a weird-ass dream. Thanks for listening, Viper. It's my pleasure, Ali. See ya. She ran off just as fast as she came. She came initially. Someone's in a hurry. Oh, Kat, there you are. Looking for you. Afternoon, Viper. Same here. Wanna ask, did you guys do anything last night to Ali? Not that I know of. Our staff leaves the cast alone at night. I guess there's nothing to worry about. Kat's been honest with me so far about everything. Right. Anyway, more importantly, it's time for phase 2. You've done pretty decently with setting up Tara and Ali as your soulmate candidates. People are eating it up. goddamn right. The moments, whatever. More importantly, every time they're on screen, we get one hell of a ratings boost. From here on out, you'll only be going on dates with either of them. That'll be your best bet to get out of here alive. Sounds good to you? You almost made it sound like I have a choice. I'm glad we're on the same page as always, Viper. But enough with the pleasantries. Who's the unlucky girl today? The unlucky girl. I did Allie last night. I think I did Allie yesterday. So I think we'll go with Tara again. Tara. All right, sounds like a plan to me. I think she's working on something in the mansion. Lead the way. I knocked on the door to the game room. Hey, Viper, what's up? I thought I'd check in and see how you're doing with your game. Let me show you what I'm working on then. Tara handed me her game device. Not all the arts are ready yet, but I'm hoping it'll be done soon. It's a foreign game. I had to ditch a pigeon thing idea after, finding out it was already done. That's really a shame for the whole world, really. But in this game, you get to live in a village out in the country, make friends, raise crops, and decimate all the invaders with your giant mecha pigeon death machine. And there's a million possible weapon combinations, and that sounds cool. Well, that sounds cool. I like to play it. I'm curious. How come you decided to make a foreign game? Good question. They just got a special place in my heart. I used to just play these morning till night, every day. Oh, sorry. Can you possibly tell? I'm not really a go out and party kind of person. To be honest, I don't know enough people to go to parties anyway, but whatever. Sometimes it's fun to just do your own thing. Yeah, sometimes it can be more fun to stay indoors and just do whatever you enjoy. That's how I feel about it. Enough talk, try playing it. I want to see how you feel about it. Alright, here we go. Tell screen display as click. Star Blue Valley. I was a mecha pilot who got tired of life in the mega crops and decided to move out to the country to become a farmer. I was a pretty good one at that. Every season I learned to plant, water, and harvest kinds of crops. Tara would give me advice for farming every season. So yeah. Her face was so close to mine. She watched my every move with a pensive expression. Farming and fishing felt great. But fishing was almost impossible to do at first. Mega parts of the game felt incredible. You could even get to know the villagers and have relationships with them too. There's just one thing that was a bit weird. First, wow. What do you have so far is incredible, Tara. You think so? Yeah, really. It's incredible. I never thought you could combine farming and being a mecha pilot in the same game. But you did it just fine. Thanks, Viper. It's nice for you to say that. There's just one thing I think that was a little off. What's that? Any feedback would be great. I feel like the relationships with the townspeople is a little bit weird. The aspect didn't really feel right. I knew you'd notice that. It's kind of embarrassing, but I never actually dated before, so I have no idea what it's really like. To be honest, I never really had a real friend either, if it's not too much to ask. Her voice suddenly reduces to a whisper. Maybe you and I could be friends. I'd be honored to be your friend. That said, please don't trap me into a video game again. Sorry, what? Anyways, watching you play gives me some ideas. Want to help me with testing them? Sure, I'd be happy to help however I can. We both suggest ideas, she implemented them, and we tested it together and repeat. It just keeps getting better and better. Tara's smile and enthusiasm was contagious. I couldn't help but be excited for her and in awe of her drive. We spent the rest of the day working on her game, but it only felt like minutes. I'm just glad it wasn't another virtual reality game. I was about to turn in for the night when I heard a knock on the door. Oh, it's Kat. Hey, Kat. I thought you weren't gonna come over tonight. Sorry about that. Got tired with some things. Is everything okay? Let's go. Good as always. Care to join me for a walk? Sure. That sounds nice. Then away we go. We walked at a relaxed pace, with Kat slightly ahead, leading the way. So how are you feeling about day 3, Viper? I still like Tara the most. Tara's still the girl I like the most. Anything I get to meet and know the other girls made me like her even more. There's no one I'd rather spend a day with than Tara. You know, there's nothing quite like that. That's cute. Also a perfect answer for the cameras. Thank you very much. Guess you'll be giving her fan base some more things to go rabbit over soon. You say that again. Perfect. Well, I'm happy you've at least got one girl you're really interested in, but helps you've got chemistry with both. Tomorrow. Oh, damn it. Keep accidentally skip. Tomorrow, we'll milk this love triangle by having one date with the girl you didn't today. That being Allie, bro. Sounds good to you? I'm noticing a pattern in making it sound like I have a choice when I really don't. None of us really have a choice nowadays, I'm afraid. Alright, I got you back. You gotta get back to editing today's footage. You ready to head back to the mansion? Sounds good to me. Walk back in comfortable silence. Night. See you later, Kat. If we get caught trying to escape, there's no telling what will happen to us. Probably get killed, probably. Unless if they don't catch your ass. The chance we have to take. I know, but we need to know what we're up against. We know the island better than anyone by now, Viper. We'll be fine. Not so sure Damien's bought in that scientist for his latest experiment. All I heard is that she's the one who built the prototype. The one Damien used to turn sticks into a vegetable. Let's mention the old test audience too. Shit. I think they must have killed at least 100 people by now, and they still haven't perfected it. If we get caught, I get what you're trying to say. Are you still with me on this? It's not too late. You didn't even have to ask. Of course I'm with you. Who are you? Somehow I know you're close by. Every time I try to see your face, the dream ends. Damn. Episode 4, second go. Gross and I kicked off that morning, testing out Terra's game together. It was a multiplayer now, so we could all play together in the same world. This came with its own fair share of consequences. I said, cover me, or yo, have to finish making dinner yourself. I'm trying. There's just too many mutant vegetables attacking. Yui, I need you to cover me. Why are you? Sorry, it's the mayor's birthday, and I can't decide which berry to give him. It can wait, but then I won't get bonus points. Funny thing of it, I think we're running low on tomatoes and carrots. Do you need any, Violet? We have enough to survive the winter, but more supplies are always welcome. I'm on it! Well, game's definitely gotten more exciting. I wanted for them to test the relationships, but maybe that'll have to wait a bit. I guess we'll see next time. Yeah, next time. I can't wait. Spend the rest of the morning playing Terra's game. Wow, this video's gone by fast, bro. Oh, we're only 16 minutes and 45 seconds in, bro. Oh, my head. Are you okay? You don't look so good. That's so loud. Oh, my head's killing me after I had a ton of wine last night. Oh, you must have been hungover, bro. Like, she probably got too drunk last night. I still had to edit our broadcast after that, which didn't help. Ladies and gentlemen, I present the woman who decides whether I get to live or die every night. And she was very, very drunk when she did just that. Thank you, I'll be here all week. Clearly, you're still alive, Viper, so it's all good. Leave me. You drink too if you worked here. Just look at the Brothers 5. Working at Futuristics Evil Corp has to come with some benefits, right? You think? But we still have to pay for dental out of pocket. Ahem, before I forgot what the show is all about. Today is the day you go on a date with. Who was the other soulmate candidate again? It was Allie, Cat. Are you too drunk to even remember names? Like, what the fuck, Cat, bro? Well, to be fair, if you're working on a show, it does sometimes get to your head, bro. So yeah, sometimes it's stress, bro. How much did you drink last night, Cat? Whatever, I knew that. Just testing you, duh. Right? Alright. Let's get the second day with Allie started. Woo! Whoa. Someone tell the world to stop spinning like a little bitch. Wait, the world was not spinning? Like... No, wait. Well, to be fair, the Earth itself spins. So, yeah. And that's how it is. I'm pretty much fucked, huh? Are you sure about that, bro? Alright. That was crazy, bro. That was fucking crazy, bro. How Cat pretends to be like drunk because of all the hard work she had to do for the show, bro. So yeah. Like, goddamn, girl, like, you're pretty entertaining too, bro. Like, anyway, so that's it for today's episode, bro. So, I'll see you guys next time. My Asian TV, sign off right now.